I hope that someday the names of Satchel Paige and Josh Gibson in some way can be added as a symbol of the great Negro players that are not here only because they were not given a chance.
One of the reasons Ted Williams was so enamored with the Negro League players was Barnstorm.
Oh man, yeah. These games were very popular, and it gave kind of a platform for the Negro League players to kind of show we belong.
Jimmy Fox and I, we went on a barnstorming trip, and we played against several teams out there that had black players on it, and some of them were damn good.
That's why I say I don't think there was ever any question about their ability to play at the major league level. If you were good enough to play in the Negro League, you were good enough to play in the major leagues.
I remember in Yankee Stadium on a Friday in 1946, the year the World Series was in Boston and St. Louis. We played the Yankee Stadium on a Friday night and a Sunday afternoon. I pitched against Satchel Paige.
The barnstorming tours that they had against the major leaguers were epic.
We had over 100,000 people in Yankee Stadium for those two ball games at major league prices. Nothing was cheap.
Bobby Feller and the 1946 barnstorming tour with Satchel. We got a great photograph. Satchel has his plane and Feller has his plane, and they hook up for 17 days of work in 1946. Each of them could earn $7,000 apiece.
I ran the whole show. I had my traveling secretary from Cleveland. I had a doctor. I had the trainers. I hired the airplanes. I flew two DC-3s, flew coast to coast.
He says Harold, he was making so much money, his wife thought he was stealing.
They made a lot of money. We made a lot of money.
And the history book bears out that the Negro League teams or the black all-star teams won almost 75% of their head-to-head matchups against their major league counterparts.
Who won the most ball games? I know, but I'm not going to mention it.
Was it close?
Fair.
Barnstorming, Harold, was a major part of the Negro League story. It would be the Negro Leagues who would take baseball into Canada. They were oftentimes the first Americans to play in many Spanish-speaking countries. Believe it or not, it was a touring team of Negro Leaguers who introduced professional baseball to the Japanese, going all the way back to 1927. This is years before Babe Ruth and his All-Stars go to Japan. They've commonly been credited with having taken professional baseball to the Japanese, but it's not true. It was a barnstorming team of Negro Leaguers called the Philadelphia Royal Giants who would go to Japan in 1927, play a 24-game exhibition series. They go 23-0-1. The tour was so successful that several years later, Ruth and his All-Stars would get invited over. We look at the game of baseball today, as you well know, in its global capacity. Well, at the heart of that were the Negro Leagues.